آمين. السلام عليكم. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على أشرف خلق الله سيدنا محمد بن عبد الله وآله وسلم عليه تسليما كثيرا. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. ربي أوزعني أن أشكر نعمتك التي أنعمت علي وعلى والدي وأن أعمل صالحا ترضاه وأصلح لي في ذريتي إني تبت إليك وإني من المسلمين. My dear brothers and sisters in Iman, we thank Allah for being able to connect with one another for His remembrance. For it is indeed through His remembrance we can be given that mercy which will allow us to exist in this world with the barakah that we deserve to receive from His mercy. In this difficult time which people are going through, the fear that is encompassing the life and livelihood of people is becoming apparent, whereby that fear is concentrated in one thing. And the only thing that is certain, everything else is unsure, but this one is certain: al-maut, death. الموت حق لا بد منه. To die is a reality, there is no escape from it. Allah mentioned the word موت in the Quran 35 times in 22 different surahs of the Quran. We as Muslims, we are supposed to be enlightened to understand and appreciate the wording of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when it was related to us in regard of every aspect of life and living. And in this one area, he concentrated and spoke in details, telling us we should prepare ourselves. But even the least knowledge of that top subject, we don't know of. For example, death is the creation of Allah. It's a creature. But we don't see it. Just like life. Allah says in the Quran, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, Surah Al-Mulk, the beginning of Surah 29, or just 29, the first surah, Surah Al-Mulk, Allah says, هو الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا. It is He, Allah, who created death, then created life. Why? So that we can be tested to see which of us will be excellent in our deeds, in our actions. So from this verse, the scholars speak and say, Allah created death and then He created life. And remember, Allah huwa al-hayy, Allah is the living. All source of life is from Him. And all death is through Him. Because one of His names, al-mumit, huwa yuhyi wa yumit. Allah said in the Quran, it is He, Allah, who gives life, and it is He who takes life. And we all should know, in Ali Imran, verse 185, Allah clearly stated and says, كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةَ الْمَوْتِ. Every life shall taste death. Every life. Even those messengers who were raised to live to eternity, they have to die. All the angels have to die. And the last angel to be existing, Israfil, the one who will blow on the sur, Allah will take away his life. And then raise him first. And then he will blow again, and everybody come out in the day of resurrection. But because we are busy, pulled in all direction by the glitter of the dunya or the world we live in, our desires are covering us. camouflaging us in our physical eyes and in our inner sight, in our heart. Hence, death is the last thing that we think of. If you ask anybody, just call them. The only time you could see them really remembering death, and it is coming out of fear, when you tell somebody, so and so died. Straight away, you hear, inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Although it is not only recited when you hear somebody died, you recite it for any test that you encompass in your life. If you fail something, if you miss something, if you are difficulty, whatever sort of difficulty you are in, automatically you need to remember this is a test. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. But as Muslims, we only repeat it when somebody has passed away. We are running away from it. And you could see it clearly today in this pandemic. People are so frightened. But really, their fear is not because they're going to lose their jobs, not because they're going to lose their way of living life. No, they're frightened to die. Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Al-Jumu'ah, verse number 8, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ قُلْ إِنَّ الْمَوْتَ الَّذِي تَفِرُّونَ مِنْهُ. Tell them, O Muhammad, the death that they are escaping away from, running away from, فَإِنَّهُ مُلَاقِيكُمْ. It is for sure going to meet you. ثُمَّ تُرَدُّونَ إِلَىٰ عَالِمِ الْغَيْبِ وَالشَّهَادَةِ. Hence you will be returned back to the knower of the apparent and the hidden. فَيُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. And he will inform you individually of what you have been doing, what you have accomplished, whether it is little or large, whether it was done openly or hiddenly, whether we are aware of it or we are not aware of it. Luqman al-Hakim, alayhi salam, the wise man, advising his son, Ya Bunay, O my son, Amrun la tadri mata yalqak. Something that you don't know when it will meet you. Ista'id lahu qabla an yufaji'ak. Prepare yourself for it before it suddenly confronts you. It comes to you at a time when you are neglectful, when you are forgetting the reality of your presence of being living in this world. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as reported in Tirmidhi, when Nisa'i, Ibn Majah, in this collection of Sahih Hadith, Abu Huraira says that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, أكثروا من ذكر هذه من لذة. O Muslims, increase the mention of the one that will remove your pleasures from your sight. Because when death comes, it's forgotten. All the desires, at the time when the person is dying, they will wish to give anything to remain alive. And by the way, what we hear now, all the professionals are talking, people who are dying, they are the elderly. This is not for the old. This is not for a specific group of people. This is for everyone when their time is finished, when their existence on this earth is no longer to be. They have to die. So now, if we are written to die in this day and age, it might be the virus will be the reason for us to die. But it might be something else. Might be an accident. Might be just normally sleeping in our bed or tripping and falling and dying, having a heart attack, whatever it is. But now everybody is linking this to the pandemic. But the fear is not really the pandemic itself. It's what it will do to destroy our life and take away our nafs in this. Allah said in Ali Imran 145, وَمَا كَانَ النَّفْسٍ أَن تَمُوتَ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. Nobody is going to die without the permission of Allah. I was astonished once, one of those huge hurricanes in America that took place and destroyed this town. Everything is destroyed. Lorries are being thrown away 3-4 miles, made into just a collection of metal. You cannot even recognize it. Homes are destroyed. One house, the top floor, all of it was taken and flown away. Everybody in that house died. 3 miles away, when they were checking the debris to see if there are bodies to collect, to bury them, they found a little baby alive. Not one scratch. We know a baby is fragile. A baby is unable to take the bigger hit. And this is a huge thing, to be flown with metal and bricks for 3 miles away and to find him under some rebels alive. Nothing touched that baby. Only Allah can do that. This verse confirms this. None will die without Allah's permission. Allah says in the Quran, قُلْ يَتَوَفَّاكُمْ مَلَكَ الْمَوْتِ الَّذِي وُكِّلَ بِكُمْ ثُمَّ إِلَى رَبِّكُمْ تُرْجَعُونَ. السجدة, verse 11. This is how this take place. Tell them, O Muhammad, the angel of death is the one who will take away your nafs. And then you are retained as a spirit to your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Surah Al-An'am, verse 61, حتى إذا جاء أحدهم الموت. When your time has come for you to be taken away from this earth, توفته رسلنا وهم لا يفرطون. Our messengers will help in taking the soul, and they will never fail. And Surah Qaf, verse 19, وَجَاءَ سَكْرَةَ الْمَوْتِ بِالْحَقِّ. And the hour of death has come with the truth. ذَلِكَ مَا كُنْتَ مِنْهُ تَحِيدٌ. This is what you are running away from. Let me tell you, these steps are like this. We're going to die asleep, or in an accident, or to be killed by someone, or through a virus like the corona. It's not haphazardly happening like that. This is planned and prepared by the Almighty Allah properly. Once you are supposed to die, five angels will be sent from Israel, the angel of death, to the person. They will accompany this person and they begin to work on removing the soul from the toes and the feet up until it reaches the throat. Once the person is dying, those who understand death, they could see it in the face of the person. You could see this person, that's it. There is no hope. Because once life leaves the lower body, it will never come back again. If the angels are working on it. Once it reaches the throat, فَإِذَا بَلَغَتِ الْحُلْقُومِ. Allah said, when it reaches the throat, now they can't do anything else. Here, because the heart is free now, it begins to see the truth. We begin to see things that are unable to present themselves to us in this physical form. We'll begin to see Iblis, for example. We begin to see angels. We begin to see ancestors who are able to attend whoever. And therefore, the person at that moment realizes nothing else can be done. For the good person, they can communicate this to those people around them. And you could see a smile in their face. And you could see their face out of joy. They say this person have light. The light is coming because out of happiness. When you are happy, there is light in your face. When you are gloomy and sad and angry, there is no light in your face. And therefore, Allah said in the Quran, فَكَشَفْنَا عَنْكَ غِطَاءُكَ فَبَصَرُكَ الْيَوْمَ حَدِيدٌ. Once it reaches the throat, we will remove the cover from the heart. And your sight, your inner sight, is sharp. You can now see what we have been speaking about, but you have no comprehension of, because you are deaf, dumb, and blind. And that is not because of us. We give you the faculties. You abuse them. You have ears. You did not listen. And you heard nothing. You have eyes. You did not observe and see and took lessons. And you had a heart, but you did not use it to reflect and comprehend the journey and the passage. As-sirat al-mustaqim. Allah says, لا عوج له. It doesn't have ways of turning left or right. It's straight. As-sirat al-mustaqim. The path that is straight. لا عوج له. No crookedness in it. But your actions, your words were crooked. Therefore, you were not in the right path. When we say somebody died in a good end, that means you died while you are in the straight path. You are dying while you are in Allah's path. So you are not going to miss him. But if you are outside, here or there, that is the bad end. And we all pray, oh Allah, we seek from you the best of ends. Allahumma inna nas'aluka husna al-khitam. Allahumma inna nas'aluka husna al-khitam. Oh Allah, we ask of you the best of ends. Because when you have the worst end, the angel of punishment will collect your body. So when the throat is receiving the nafs, the eyes that will turn, and this turning of the eyes, because the heart now, this eye no longer function. The person sees from inside, sees all directions, sees through even walls, sees from distances. For the lucky ones, they could even be seeing Rasulullah sitting next to them. And there, from the heavens, with a spear of light, Israel takes it. When the person goes, yes, shaqqa. This gasping of air from the mouth of the person and the falling of their head to the right or left or to the back, that's it. That means it is being taken. For some, it's like taking a hair out of a dough. Simple. For others, it's like taking a nail that is rusty from an old, hard piece of wood. They scream and they fight, but it will be taken. Therefore, we need to think of this. Wallahi, if there is any good reminder in these days, we need to think all of us at any time we could leave. Yesterday, there were many brothers around us, sitting around us, reading with us. Where is Dr. Khalid? MashaAllah, every Saturday he was there, bringing his sweets, talking to people, embracing everybody. Where is Ahmed Nadir? The one who was always rushing and talking to us and telling us things and bringing joy and happiness. Where is Brother Fuad Nahdi? Where is Brother Fahim, who used to bring us the food every Friday? And I can mention other names, too many. They're all gone. Because death is for everyone. Not just because of the corona, we're going to die. No. If it is written we die here, it might be the cause. It might not be the cause. Hence, please, before the hour comes and then we do that which Allah doesn't want us to do. A person who's finding it hard will say, Rabbi rju'un, my Lord, let them give me a chance to be retained to live my life as it was. The malaika, when they hear the person saying this, they say, how foolish is this? You're going to meet your Lord. How can you want to go back to this prison you are in? Why? لعلي أصدق، لعلي may, perhaps maybe I can have a chance to be charitable. الله أكبر. صدق رسول الله. The messenger peace be upon him had spoken the truth when he said الصدقة برهان. Charity is the real proof that a person believes in Allah. Not just in giving money, in giving your time by volunteering to help and support any cause. Whatever you know, helping somebody else is a sign of goodness. خير الناس من ينفع الناس. The best of people is the one who offers himself in any capacity to help other people. And therefore, we need to make sure that we remember. I'm going to finish with this. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu. I came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam house, and before me there were 9, I became the 10th. One of the Ansar of Medina sitting with the Prophet says to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, من أكيس الناس وأكرم الناس يا رسول الله. Who is the most intelligent and honorable of people, O Messenger of Allah? The Prophet ﷺ says, أكثرهم ذكرا للموت. The one who remembered death more than anybody else. وأشدهم استعدادا له. And the one who is most ready for death. أولئك هم الأكياس. Those are the intelligent, clever ones. ذهبوا بشرف الدنيا وكرامة الآخرة. For them is the honor of this world and the honor of the hereafter. Reported by Ibn Majah, Ibn Abi Dunya. So we need to remember death. We need to do a lot of righteous good actions. We need to do a lot of charitable acts. And we need to make sure that we write a will, because we don't know when we're going to die. And specifically, if we have debt, we borrowed anything, even a rotten second-hand tool from somebody, we should write down, believe this should be returned to so and so. Because debt is a big problem. No payment in the day of judgment with material money. The payment for those who want to be paid because you do not return back what they give to you is taking away from your good deeds. If you don't have good deeds, taking from their bad deeds. Hence, we will be running from one another. Allah said in the Quran, يَوْمَ يَفُرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ, when the person will be running away from his brother. وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ, and his mother and his father. وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَبَنِيهِ, and his wife or partner and his children. Why? لكل امرئ منهم يومئذ شأن يغنيه. For each one of them, his own problems, his own dilemmas, his own worries. Nobody wants to take more worries. So please, remember this. And keep this dhikr. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. We are living at a tough time. At least every day, repeat it 70 times. 100 times or more. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Either this is happening to us, it's good. When we hear somebody died, we need to ask if they have debt, if they are family members, so we can help in paying the debt back. We need to pray for them. We need to give charity in their name. We can even make prayer. We can fast. We can make umrah or hajj by the intention that Allah will write it in their books. For they cannot do for themselves. They have died. We who are alive can do on their behalf. As the hadith says, the children of Adam, their book is closed once they die. They are unable to do for themselves. Only a charity they leave, people benefit from, or knowledge people benefit from, or good children who keep praying for them. Please Let us remember those who passed away and pray for them. And let us ask Allah to give us the tawfiq, the success, to be able to hold together in these tough days. I'm going to finish, and alhamdulillah, I could see my brother Ismail with us. Yesterday, he rang me and mentioned something to me, and it is astonishing. He says somebody rang him and said to him, Sheikh Abdul Mahmoud and Sheikh Babikir made istikhara, and they said that this injection for vaccination is poison. Astaghfirullah. I would never say such a thing. For the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, Allah has created the medicine before he created the disease to give us the chance to look for the reason. Allah said, وَجَعَلْنَا لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ سَبَبًا. We read in Surah Yasin, for everything, there must be a reason. We must find that reason. The medicine is a reason for shifa. All those scientists who are investigating, they are doing a fantastic job. I can't remember how many vaccinations I have taken in my life. I've taken too many. And this one, is very. And alhamdulillah, I have already taken my vaccination. My first injection, it's been taken. Because work with homeless people as in social work, myself and the staff, we've taken the injection. Alhamdulillah. Please, if you are asked to take it, you are lucky enough to be called, take it. Remember, by not taking it, you are not accepting that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created the disease to test you and created the medicine to give you the opportunity not to be the cause for causing others to be frightened of this. So when I take my injection, not just to save myself, so that I will not be able to carry it for other people. That's the whole idea. Once everybody is vaccinated, then people can mix and people can go together. It's when you are traveling to Hajj, by the way, in some years they ask you to have yellow fever because sometimes you must, cholera. I have taken cholera, I have taken yellow fever many times. Why? Because if you go and carry the disease, people die, you are responsible. And if you are carrying it and bring it back to where you came from, you're also responsible. So please encourage people and ask them to save themselves so that they can save others. None of us is a true believer, a genuine believer, an honorable, honest believer until we love for others what we love for ourselves. If we love to be safe, we should love safety for others, inshallah. Mustafa, assalamu alaikum. How are you, my brother? Are you all right? Are you with the family?
They will find, alhamdulillah.
Shukullah. I think lawyers are not in the front line, so I think you will be called late. You're going to be called later, but may Allah make it easier for all of you to be called, inshallah. Alhamdulillah. Amen. Allah bless you, Sidi. How are you, Sidi Ismail? Are you well?
Alhamdulillah, Sheikh. Thank you so much. Alhamdulillah. May Allah bless you.
Please spread the word. I never said such rubbish.
I will.
Where that brother heard it from? This is rumors. We are living in a time whereby people spread a lot of rumors for no reason. I will never encourage people not to take medicine. Medicine is very important. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam encouraged before he could touch person with his hand and they are healed. But always ask, is there anybody who can heal this person? Is there somebody who can do a medicine? Khalas, we do that first. Then we do the other things, inshallah. Inshallah. Allah bless you. Look after yourself. Jahid, how are you?
Thank you.
How are you, Sayyidi? How are you, Sheikh?
Alhamdulillah, are you well?
Alhamdulillah, thank you.
May Allah bless you and look after you. Akif, how are you?
Alhamdulillah, Sheikh, thank you. I'm very well.
Life, sorry, treating you well?
Alhamdulillah, very well. I'm sorry, yesterday the line got very cut. I couldn't hear anything.
No, the internet was not really strong. And nowadays, because there is too much demand on it, you see.
Yes.
All teachers were teaching during the day.
Yeah.
And my wife is a teacher. My son also teaches dentistry. Sometimes he's using his computer teaching. So sometimes we find it very heavy. Yeah. Everybody is using. But alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, it's good. Alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah.
All others who cannot see me, assalamu alaikum, all of you. Or I cannot see you. May Allah bless you all. Let us make dua. We have a brother called Saeed, who used to be he lives in Baker Street, next to Central Mosque. He's one of the really Egyptian brothers from South Egypt, North Sudan. He's a a businessman who used to sell food to people. He bring his van in front of center of Mokhobi, a white little van. He passed away yesterday morning through this virus as well. We pray for him that Allah will bless his soul and grant him a high place in Jannah. And we will also pray for all those who passed away, whether we know them or not. And our brothers, especially Brother Fahim and his son As-Sadiq, Dr. Fuad Nahdi, Dr. Khalid, and we pray also for Ahmed Nazir. And we pray for all our brothers who used to be with us, Brother Qasim Mustafa, and others. There are too many names to remember. May Allah bless all their souls. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Qul huwallahu ahad, Allahus Samad. Lam yalid wa lam yulad wa lam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Qul huwallahu ahad. Allahus Samad lam yalid wa lam yulad wa lam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Qul huwallahu ahad. Allahus Samad lam yalid wa lam yulad wa lam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. Ya wahid ya ahad, ya fard ya samad. Ya man lam yalid wa lam yulad wa lam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. We ask of you to write the reward of Surah Al-Ikhlas in the book of our brother Sa'id. And may you raise him to the highest loftiest place in Jannah. May he be raised with the pious and righteous among the prophets and the messengers and the martyrs and the righteous ones with Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May he drink from his blessed right hand a drink that will never be thirsty thereafter, Ya Kareem. O Allah, allow us all to leave this world in the best of ways, to be raised among the righteous, Ya Kareem, and to dwell with Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Firdaus al-A'la. To all our brothers whom I mentioned their names and the others, may Allah bless their soul and grant them the highest loftiest place in Jannah. To all the awliya, those who have passed away and those who are alive. To all the prophets and the messengers. To all their companions. To all the people who have always strived to do good. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them and guard them and strengthen them. And through them, may Allah allow us to survive the difficulties of this world and to always be steadfast in the straight path, Ya Kareem. Rabbana ihdina as-sirata al-mustaqim. Ya Allah, ihdina as-sirata al-mustaqim waj'alna min 'abidika dawi at-taqwati wal-rahmati wal-barakati min ladunka, Ya Kareem. Wa salli wa sallim ala sayyidina Muhammad wa alihi wa sallim. Anybody listening now, they have anything in their life that they are seeking from Allah that will please him and be good for them, may Allah fulfill it. And if it is not, may Allah provide for them the best of solution and the best of openings. Wa salli Allahumma ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa alihi wa sallim. Ana rabbika rabbil ata amma yasifun wa salamun ala mursaleen. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Al-Fatiha. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Ar-Rahmanirrahim. Malik yawmiddin. Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka nasta'in. Ihdina as-sirata al-mustaqim. Sirata al-lazina an'amta alayhim ghayri al-maghdubi alayhim wa la-dhalin. Ameen. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.